Well, more than 6,000 runners from all over the state, country, and the world competed in Maine's largest road race today. Of course, we're talking about the Beach to Beacon in Cape Elizabeth. This was the 16th year for the race. WMTW News 8's Katie Thompson takes a closer look at today's event.
Micah Kogo!
For the second time in 3 years at the Beach to Beacon 10K, Micah Kogo of Kenya took home the top honors, finishing first overall with a time of 28 minutes and 3 seconds.
For me, for the second time now, it's a nice course for me because I know where I can break the group.
It's a destination road race for thousands of runners looking to compete alongside some of the sport's most elite athletes.
Probably the most beautiful finish line, at least that I've ever seen anywhere in the world, and certainly the most hospitable, hands down the most hospitable of races around the world. So it's no surprise with Joan Benoit Samuelson as the founder that you're going to get an experience like this.
Riley Masters!
For Maine runners like Riley Masters, it's a rite of passage, one he completed today, becoming this year's top male finisher from Maine.
Everyone in Maine who grows up here knows about the Beach to Beacon, and I think it's a goal of just about everyone's to try to be first Mainer, and that was my goal today, and just, yeah, a lot of Maine pride crossing the finish line first.
24-year-old Erica Jessamine changed the pace of the women's race. She was the first Maine female to cross the finish line.
You know, you have to pray for the victims of Boston, and a lot of them can't do this, and I'm very blessed to be able to do this, so very lucky.
Boston Marathon bombing survivor Karen Rand making an appearance as the official starter, showing that the Cape Elizabeth race was indeed Boston strong. It was another successful year for a 10K that's gained respect from athletes across the nation and worldwide. In Cape Elizabeth, Katie Thompson, WMTW News 8.